Sekou B is a producer, also an artist. My real name is Gabriel Guini, and Sekou B is the name which I use in this music cycle. Actually, the music thing started way back in when I finished my O-level examination in 1996. And then by then, I started doing music, like doing the singing, actually. We did a hit single that was called Marimba back then with the group called Mud Steppers. And then from there, recording was a hassle. To come up with a song, it was something which was hard by then. And then I took a break, trying to build up a studio. And then from that time up to 2005, that's when I came up with a studio called Luck Beats and Vibes. Way back, I used to be in Kadoma. Actually, what inspired me, I used to listen to R. Kelly's music a lot and Boyz II Men. I used to like their style. So before, I used to dance. And then I decided to quit on dancing. And then I started to sing. Like, I used to do like lip syncing on songs of R. Kelly and Boyz II Men. And then this other friend of mine told me, why are you singing some other people's songs? Why don't you come up with your own song? And then I started writing. And then I came up with songs, and then I see, at least I can do this. And then by then I started doing music, and then when I shifted to do gospel, to production. And then that's when I started doing production, because to record, it was so hard that we used to walk a long distance in studio. By that time, they were very, very few. So I thought to come up with a studio so that things may be easy for me and others as well, so that it will be easy for us to record. When I used to do music, like when I used to sing, I worked with people like Trevor Dongo. I did a track with Trevor Dongo way back. That was in 2009. And then I did a track with Nguni Kambarami and Shinzo and Alexio Kawara. Yeah, I used to like, it was secular love songs. Yeah, I worked with those guys. We did well, but I was still producing. It was all those songs, I produced them. So I was like working as a producer and singing as well. And then up to 2005, I switched to gospel. And then that's when actually I made a breakthrough. I did a song called Pupura. It was a gospel track, an Afro jazz track. It really did well on the market scene, and it entered in Power FM charts. It did well in the singing cycle. So actually this was like the song which actually made a breakthrough in the music cycle, the song called Pupura. Some say music, it's not good, it's bad. Like many people, they do drugs and stuff. But I can come with another approach. Music is it's an inspiration, it inspires, it uplifts. Actually, for example, you've been working the whole day and you're tired, you want to rest, you have to listen to music, to play to music so that it will calm you down. But some people, they think music, they associate it with bad things. Yes, there are some people who do music in a bad way, but to me, the way I see music, it actually heals, it helps, especially when you're singing physically, it heals. And if you're listening to it, you can actually forget about so many problems which you are facing because music will be calming you down. So I see music as a positive in a way whereby it helps a lot of people, in those who are in need actually.
Tell them that you get your Miss Royal, so don't destroy up in general.
If you call and I don't pick up, I'm just putting in the work. And if I got a pen and paper, you know that's a killer verse. I say pretty, I say gem, and got some rappers trying to kick. Now I don't know what you call that, but I call it God's grace. I say this, it was my year, that was journal what refreshed. I told this girl to wet the space, and they all thought I wasn't safe. See, the mistake they made was thinking that I'm just afraid of faith. They never thought I'd drop them bars, I'm a book under arrest. Kick on the beat, watch me make my haters dance. I can slay in my jeans, I can slay in my dress. And some feel so wide if I know hands, and that will make a sense. I can pretty much do anything and do it at my best. I came here to win, I came to put those girls to rest. Probably the youngest chick that's doing it, so pay me some respect. Look, I won and that for Mike, watch your zivas, let you change her. I'm a real game changer, my two time under the pizza.
My name is Tiffany, my stage name is Tiffcake, and I'm a hip hop artist. I've done quite a number of songs, although there's only one single, which is currently playing on the Hip Hop Basement right now. The ones I did before were just features, because I was just starting. And so, yeah. I have been working with Circle B for about 2 months now. That's when I moved to Harare. I was based in Koko before, so I was working with other producers before that. So when I moved here, I was looking for someone who shared the same vision, and then I got his contact, and we started talking and started doing business there. He's helped improve my music a lot. There are a lot of stuff that I didn't know before that I know now when it comes to music production, even when it comes to how I should present myself as an artist. There are a lot of things that I've learned in these 2 months that I didn't learn in the time that I started doing music before. In the next few years, I definitely see myself on the latest music channels. I want to see myself in Trace. I want to see myself performing in different countries. I want to travel like the other artists that I know. I just want to grow as an artist and better music, do better songs with bigger artists.
I'm Miss Royal, real name Linda Roya. I started doing music in 2016. I had my first track with Lil Saint, the one who works with the great Stacko B. Then I started like doing some other things, but now I'm back to music. I've been working with Stacko B for the past 6 months, and I don't lie, it's been a good experience. I've been taught. Because I'm a person who's kind of shy. I'm afraid at times, but it's been giving me courage, teaching me many things.
Actually, in music, it's not just easy. Like for me, I started way back in 1996, but look where I am now. So you have to be serious, and you have to persevere. You have to keep on pushing and never give up. There are so many things which you come across in the music scene, but you really need to be serious in what you're doing. And I used to work with a lot of people. Some they gave up, some they are now doing other things, but I'm still doing music. So it's not a thing whereby you just wake up tomorrow and you are there on top, but it's something whereby you need to study, you need to work hard, you need to plan and find ways whereby you have to make a breakthrough. So music is not a thing whereby you just wake up in the morning, you're there on top. It's not like that. But it's something whereby you need to work hard. So what I can say to all those who want to do music, all those who are in music already, be serious. And being serious doesn't mean that you can sing or what, but it's the effort you put in what you're doing. So keep on pushing. It will eventually one day be a success. Actually, yeah, there are some times whereby you think of giving up, because it's like when you want something to happen the way you want it, and then you see that thing, it's not like going the way you want, you see yourself like you want to give up. It's like when you're working hard and there's no success, you feel like giving up. It's like nowadays, a lot of artists, we are so many, there are so many artists and few radio stations. Like you have done a good song, you see yourself, it's a track, it's a bomb. But you put the song out there and then it's not being played. You feel like, what have I done wrong? Is the track not on point? But the track will be on point. But it's not like the way you want things to be done, it's not like that. So sometimes you feel like, let me just give up, it's not my calling. But you really need to give up. And actually, what kept me going is like, I refer myself, I read a lot, like the Bible, when the Word of God says you should never give up, and God gives us strength. Actually, there are so many stories in the Bible which actually keep me going, whereby you feel like I want to give up, but at the end of the day, you start seeing a light, and that's where when you see yourself like waperewa, that's where God starts opening so many avenues. So you should never give up, but there are some times where you feel like you want to give up. For example, pane story yekuti munaichera goride, and then ashika pa like 2 meters kuti asvike pane goride, obvatanga kudzokera mashure, and then obvatouya pawasira ipapo ongochera 2 meters usvika pane goride. Saka zvinhu zvekuti you might want to give up while you are almost there. So it's like you will never know when you see kuti panapa ndasvika. So you should keep on working hard, and one day you'll see things flowing. Okay, actually, what made me like decide to stick to producing, it's like I did, I produced a song for Shinso and Trevor and Ngoni Kambarami and Alexio. So it's something like it made me realize that at least when people come to me, say they want to be produced and I'm doing tracks where they are being appreciated and being played on radio stations, it's like it made me like feel like, hey, at least I should keep on doing this. And it opened so many doors. Like a young artist, they've that mindset whereby if you produced a well-known artist, they will all come rushing to you, want to be produced as well. So it's like that's what actually kept me going, and I did great project with those guys. And the other thing is, you should know what programs to use so that you come up with a good product. It's not all about being a producer, but it's the quality and the stuff you are making. You need to come up with good stuff so that people they appreciate and they decide to come and work with you. So it's like, to be a producer, know your programs, know your softwares which you are using, and you should know how to use them and be skillful in using them so that you come up with something unique whereby people like working with you. What I have achieved, like if I see like those big stars, I made an impact in their life to be where they are. So actually when I look at some of those big artists, I feel proud, because I put a hand to be where they are. I produced a lot of hits. It's a numberless. I can't actually count them, but I did a lot of hits, which I did. And right now I'm working with Toba Don. He's got this hit single which is being played on the radios. If you actually a radio listener, so there are so many hits to say. January, December, Skirao, Bagada Gutaka Nange Quachiremba, Kunza Wangu Rasa Wangu Semba, Mangandeva Siso, Machaira, Skirira Vera Sikomu, Apagdira Vanto Dira Uri Mugomo, Ipatanira Vanange Kumatigo. Okay, when I'm creating a beat, actually what inspires me first is the artist. If an artist comes with a unique melody, I feel like inspired, I feel energetic. Because I can't let that melody go just away, just like that. I feel challenged to come up with something more which matches that melody, which is nice. So actually, when I'm sometimes I can create a beat on my own, and then an artist just comes and listen and then just put a flow. But what actually I like the most when the artist comes with a melody, say could be, this is my melody, can you create this? And then I feel challenged, I start making which matches that standard. I'm working with Toba Don. Watch out for Toba Don. We have projects which we are working on, and he's doing well. And this young man called Little Saint, we did some couple tracks. Yeah, he's coming out well, because we did a single called Zolmeta Soul. It's a love track, a mixture, a fusion of soul and hip-hop. It's doing well on the radio, on the market scene. And this young man called Alexio Chiwara, he's into gospel. I collaborated him with Wenzin Postori, the one from Zim Praise. Now I see music, it's now on the peak, because if you actually watch or see, we've got artists who are being played on Trust TV. So we actually have international Zim artists which are going international. So I see now Zimbabwe music industry has come to the peak, whereby if you listen to our quality, it's now almost the same with quality from UK, America. We now actually have that standard whereby if we put our product like on the internet, actually people from outside the country, they're actually appreciating our quality. So I see we are there. For example, like if you look at the song ya Tami Takura na Toba Don, beautiful. It was on Trace and it made it in per that number top 10 every year. So if you see a Zimbabwean artist being in those chats, you see we are making it. And a Teeth Cake, they are making it on the hip hop scene, Vachi Rova International. So Zurubit. And the shut up walking in, teach it and let it out in the same place. Chilling with people with two faced, letting them take over my space, letting them run over my race, yeah, my race. Oh, Mono S is telling you what to do and who you are. So you tell them straight on, mama raise me right now. Otherwise, none.
From God that's created to blow, and the panas are not quitting. They know that power you have for you. They try to break you so that you just lose. Devils are liars, just dash on them. You know that you can be anything. You can live your dreams and fantasies.
No, how's easy, but you shouldn't give in until you have everything. I am a living testimony.
There are no major challenges, but what I can say is you produced a hit song and you expect that song to be marketed or promoted, and there are no promoters. So as us producers, sometimes artists won't come to be produced because they feel like discouraged or feel like trying to give up because you have produced a hit, but promoters are not promoting it. The song is not like doing what it was supposed to be done, and then that person will see or will think like this producer, he didn't actually did my track well. You find another producer, but it's not like you have done a wrong production. You have done the good thing, but maybe promoters are not like there to promote your song. So artists will feel like, maybe let me try another producer.
Find a disaster, baby, no.